It used to be 25 cents in the subways, and I would buy one to bring to my mother, because that was her favorite flower. And when I heard that Freilacher was gone, what came to mind was the picture of Garrett Lanson, the drawing of Garrett Lanson, how great and hardly known for Garrett Lanson. Beautiful drawing of this mystery poet, of all the beauty and youth of his life. When I first met him, his sweetheart was named Albert, in America. So that's what I just heard. I knew about that. Thank you for those poems. So, how many hats wore the gardenia recently? I haven't been able to find one. The forest still carries. Every April 7th, I want one from my mother. There have been years on, but I still don't know. So, not so long ago, I think this is a book. Not so long ago, it was published by Spartan Lord Darwin, a book of marvelous photos, marvelous drawings, she calls them, what I call them, paintings, by Matthew Tavassi, who's here, in this room, somewhere. And she let me write poems to them, and from them, I should say from them. I like writing from artwork. This is one that goes with this image. You can see why I call them paintings. An arrow says, a stick points both ways at once, even when it points the other way. An arrow lets music happen to space. How? How does it do that? It leaps. The French say, il saute aux yeux, it leaps to the eyes. The in eye, the out eye, the other eye, the eye that hears music. So it's a table, a drum, an eardrum. So it's a table, small, the people around it, and their knees touching under, unseen limb of the other, a table hides, a single mark on a piece of paper is a lock. Look, lock, open and go in. The ancients knew it, any mark of the seal, the sigil, the way in. Here there is a hard mark and it opens. Far away is a wall and a room and a painting on the wall. It is a painting of your mother, maybe, or my mother, my poor mother. The mark is my mother. A mark is a mother. I'm going back from painting. I mean, looking at them. I don't do them. Supposed to be the Christmas poem. Every year I write a Christmas poem for everybody else. I send it out in the cheapest possible way on the internet. You may get one too. But writing it is a difficult thing. I mean, for one thing, I'm not much of a Christian. Is anybody? But this is supposed to be the Christmas poem. But across the stream, men are piling up boulders and loose stones. I think the earth is telling them to do this. A hollow sound, auscultation, a physician pounding the earth's chest. Not. Earth needs no doctoring. Earth is permanent enough. The rocks beneath us, we also stand firm. No fracking in this state. Rock under, sky over. Let it be. Except these pyramid guys, these know how to walk. Oh, well, the earth is so far away, maybe. Maybe this little stone is part of it. And this last one called Abandoned. Let it be a piece of why not wood, or a script the Hittites used and abandoned. Let it be abandoned like a house in the woods, where Ted Elston found a whole library of homeopathy, 100 years of books, and learned what the house had to tell. Or let it be abandoned the way a child is at the door of a convent, then grows up famous, you know the story, a swordsman or a queen, something you think you we would never really want to be, or like a piece of paper let fall to the sand, a half-written letter on it, all emotion and no address, no signature. The whole world suffers like this. Sometimes I think there are massive spelling errors all around us. Or am I abandoned too, like a boy who brings his books back long overdue to the beautiful librarian he's in love with, who should find at last something to talk to him about.